Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Zoo Tycoon Diaries, the Challenge Zoo. It is me, Ralphie993, and in the last episode, there's a game challenge. In the last episode, we successfully completed two game challenges, even. We made a Skytram, and we just gave somebody our Markhor and immediately got a point towards that, so that was kind of awesome. Game challenge. The magazine Zoo Fan Quarterly has prepared an article about successful zoo tours called Hit the Road for a future issue. If you can raise $1,000 in donations from a Jeep vehicle tour within the next 2 months, Zoo Fan Quarterly will describe your accomplishment for the next issue. If you succeed, the good publicity will attract extra guests to your zoo and increase your zoo fame. If you fail, though, attendance at your zoo will decline slightly. Difficulty hard. Well, I think at the beginning I said I would accept every challenge, but honestly, this probably isn't a good one for us to accept. We just did a zoo tour. We just have a zoo tour put up. Nobody's going to go on another zoo tour right after they go on the first one, I don't think. Plus, there's not really any room. I'd have to like reconfigure exhibits and stuff to make a Jeep vehicle tour because they take up more space in exhibits, as I mentioned in the previous episode. Plus, it's hard. And you have to raise $1,000 in 2 months. I'm going to actually decline this challenge and hope for a different one, despite that. It might come up later again, like I'll just be shuffled back into the roster of challenges that we can get. But yeah, that's probably not a good one for us to take on right now. And I don't want to be like wasting our time, because I want to like get the challenges and stuff done. So yeah, that's that. Yeah, we got this awesome like zoo tour though. How much money did we earn though in the little bit? Wow, we've earned over 10 grand in donations. Average donation, $200. Holy crap. That's awesome. So we definitely could have gotten the number of donations, mind you. But yeah, I just don't think it might not have been the right time to do that sort of challenge. But what I am going to do now, we're at 4.5 stars of fame, which is super awesome. But I think I'm going to add in a few new animals just to kind of liven up our zoo a little bit. It's been kind of, well, I guess last episode I added new exhibit, but granted, it felt like forever ago because it took me forever to play that episode. So I'll either meet you back when I have a new exhibit or when a new game challenge presents itself. Either or. Oh, okay, game challenge. The Species Diversity Fund has created a program to reward zoos that can prove they have happy, well-adjusted animals from a wide variety of different species. If you can take 3 photos of different animals exhibiting specific behaviors, the Species Diversity Fund will give you a specimen of a species you don't already have in your zoo. The particular photos they want to see are an emperor penguin doing a preening walk, one okapi play-chasing another, and a Nile crocodile blowing bubbles in the water. Difficulty moderate. Alright, I will accept this one. We can make that work. I was actually making a spectacle bear exhibit, though, which is not one of our species, but I think we can do this, because we have no crocodiles. The okapis we can maybe put with the bear tapirs. I think there might be enough room if maybe we release some of the younger ones to the wild, and we can easily get penguins. Do we even have penguins and okapis available? That's our next question. We don't. So let's work on that. Penguins, okapis. I'm leaving the spectacle bears, because I want spectacle bears. Alright, let's just actually put them in now so that I don't forget. There we go. And we got more famousness. Bear taper wants to meet but can't reproduce, blah blah blah. Okay, fine. Releasing you into the wild. The tapers live quite a long while. We already have a bunch of gazelles dying. Unfortunately, the sort of, not lesser herbivores, but the lesser herbivores tend to die off really quickly. I think flamingos have the shortest lifespan out of all the Zoo Tycoon animals. They don't seem to last very long at all. That's really, really deep and not gonna work. There we go. Oh, research for the family restaurant. I also researched the restaurant here because I didn't want to build a whole new food court because I'm a little bit lazy. So, bam! Restaurant. That'll work. So, let's see here. American Bison 3 is really hungry. Why are you hungry? What is wrong with this thing? Are you just glitching out? Eat the freak- I caged the secretary bird so it wouldn't scare you all the time. I kind of like to make the sleeping area for any exhibit more thickly treed and vegetated, so it's kind of mimicking like, oh, their privacy, they would go hide away in the bushes, that's where their sleeping area was going to be. I don't know if that actually works or not. And they kind of have like sparser trees closer to the front so that we guests can also see into the exhibit really well without having trees block the way, because the trees will block the way of guests' viewing area and they will be upset by that. And we don't want upset guests. We want guests to be able to see our animal. Okay, now that the bears are kind of dealt with over there, we'll go look at them later. But let's check out if we can get these Nile crocodiles to blow bubbles. Plan to put stuff prey down. Usually they blow bubbles when they're dirty. So we'll have to. That one might have a high hygiene requirement. This guy already kind of does. So as long as the freaking zookeeper doesn't interfere with that, we should be okay for these guys. But while none of them seem to be dirty at the moment, let's see if we can put some okapis in our tapir exhibit. So one, where's the little one? I thought there was a baby. Or maybe you're just really, really pregnant, that's all. Okay. That's fine. Oh, we do have an okapi now. Okay, so space is okay. Everybody's happy. Space is still okay. Sweet, this is a big exhibit, so hopefully it was gonna be. But the okapis do require a lot of space than most other animal species in this game, so it's always good to make note of that. But let's just move us. Oh, we'll make another tiny water dish over here as well for the okapis. Okapis don't have any shelter requirements. They do have a scratching post, though, which should already be in the exhibit. Or maybe not. Now it is. A salt lick. So that's all good. We can have more trees and stuff. This exhibit hasn't really been upgraded with foliage recently. But, eh, what's a person gonna do? I kind of build these exhibits and then kind of forget about them. There, it's kind of upgraded now. But my oryxes are dying. They usually die after they have their second baby, which is kind of sad. So then the sibling has to look after the baby. But hopefully it's old enough. It doesn't have to be with its mother. Otherwise, it's really sad. But okay, so we got okapis. Cool. They'll chase each other. Oh, African Tycoon Award. Great work. As a reward for having 10 African species in your zoo, the African Jeep vehicles. Oh, cool. That's awesome. So unlock that. Actually, African species are usually like the most common species to find in a zoo. But investigate food dish. So these guys will chase each other when their social need starts to press. So because I don't want them to chase each other without me looking, and we don't have to wait for their needs to arise. I'm gonna come over here to see if any of these guys are gonna start cleaning themselves. Going into water, standing, going into water. So let's just monitor these guys for a bit. Yeah, we want them blowing bubbles. Blowing bubbles might be a mating thing they do. I'm gonna release you into the wild, because you're not gonna mate with your mother, because that's a little weird. Maybe with him gone. Oh, but there is already an egg in here somewhere. So it actually might take a while for us to see them blowing bubbles. Unless we put another female crocodile in. That's always a possibility. Let's check out our okapis again. Just kind of go back and forth between the two. Oh, are you chasing the other one? Or are you running around? Don't do that to me. You scared me. Behaving aggressively towards Jaguar 1. Well, don't spend all your time doing that. I just realized that this fencing is not high enough to contain okapi, and they could easily jump out. I don't know if they would, but they might. Oh. Transport. Oh, we must have delivered 100 guests on our tram system. Woohoo! Awards for us! Oh! Layers year one of our game. First anniversary world. We get bronze. Looks more goldish than bronze, but whatever. Actually, I think what I'm gonna do. Because if these guys don't do the blowing bubbles unless they're mating, and they have a child, they're not gonna mate. I'm going to adopt it out. Go give it to another zoo. And see if that triggers any sort of mating between these two crocodiles, because our okapis too haven't really done anything, because they're not really friendly enough with each other. So all the male. I think it's the male that's going to be blowing the bubbles. Refreshing. Nope, they're still thrashing. It's blowing bubbles. Okay, so let's position ourselves so we get a good picture. Because we're going to do PC spacebar. First person view, camera, snap photo. So PC picture. There we go. Cool, even though I see absolutely no bubbles anywhere. Sure. Okay. But there, that's done. So that's the first photo. So, second photo, I guess it's going to be between these. Oh, what are you doing? Play chasing okapi too. Look how perfect that was. You're gonna be a filthy okapi in your photo, but whatever. It will still work. So, PC to camera snap with a tapir in the foreground. Awesome. Yeah, I don't ever try to get, like, actual good pictures unless I'm looking for good pictures that I'm taking myself. Alright, so the last thing we just need to do is do the penguins, and I haven't got any penguins yet, but I will let you know when we got penguins we can adopt. Ah, penguins! There we go, finally. Finally they showed up. Alright, that took a little while, but that's okay. Let's see, we kind of got already a penguin exhibit started up here, so I'm just going to continue the fence, not the fence line, pathway. So we can get ourselves penguin. And it said to do a preening walk we need the photo of. So that makes me think that it also needs to have kind of a low hygiene level. Or a really high one, rather. It's kind of weird. Like, the level of it needs to be high and pressing in order for it to clean itself. But let's just kind of make sure we got enough penguin goodies in here. Two females and a single male. Even though they're monogamous, he's going to mate with both of them. I think everybody's heading into the water, because that's what penguins do. So we'll just wait until one of them gets filthy enough and snap a picture of it. And maybe we'll make this also. I think I've only done one challenge so far this episode. Let's see here. The posters. Was that this episode or last episode? Oh no, that was that episode. Yeah, this is the only challenge we've done so far this episode. But that might be okay because it's kind of running up a little bit on time. Oh yeah, because I declined the other challenge. So technically it could still be a two challenge episode. It just wasn't two challenges completed, but two challenges presented. Maybe? Will that work? I don't know. You're pooping right next to where you eat. That's good to know. You should clean yourself, penguin. You're all shitty. Oh! Preening feathers. Is that the same thing as a preening walk? We're gonna see. No. Not necessarily. Okay, it needs to do a preening walk, not preening its feathers. Is a preening walk a mating thing? Possibly. So we're gonna have to wait for these guys to become buddy-buddy enough with each other that one of them wants to do the other. Oh. Oh, we got $25,000 in donations. That's cool. You don't even know what a lion is. How can you be behaving aggressively towards it? Oh, preening walk! Right there! Perfect! Okay, so yeah, it's kind of like, ooh, look at me, I'm fancy pants penguin, which penguins are pretty fancy looking, let's be honest. So, P, C, C, snap! I missed it? Oh, but that one's doing it. They're both doing it. There, we got two pictures. Or two penguins for one picture. The people at the Species Diversity Fund were extremely impressed with your photos. You convinced them that your zoo has a diverse and happy collection of animals. As a reward, they presented you with a new animal, which has been created and placed near the entrance of your zoo. What did they give us? What did they give us? Oh! Photo yes, we got the jungle-themed buildings! Sweet! So now we just need two game challenges and one endangered species, and we'll be done with this sort of thing. Alright. Oh, excuse me. Where's my new animal? Oh, right there. Oh, a fennec fox! That's adorable! Oh, we got a 5-star zoo! Guys, we have a 5-star zoo. We are rocking this. Let's just put the fennec fox in there. I think he should be fine in there. No one's gonna give him any troubles. No hardships. Give him a ball to play with. He can have a bone to play with. Make sure he has a food dish low enough for him to drink out of, though. Otherwise, that could pose some problems. But yeah, usually fennec fox are pretty adorable, and they're never a problem for these bigger animals, because a little fennec fox is not going to harm a camel or a oryx. But that's super cute. Look how little and cute he is. We should maybe get her a mate, though. He's not a he. It's a she. But I wonder if she needs a mate, or if she can satisfy her needs. Make her a desert burrow. Or if she can satisfy her social needs. What are you doing? What are you running towards? Don't hurt my little fox. She's adorable. Will you be friends with the fox? I'm going to eat the meat. I don't know. Oh, she's cute. Let's go look at her. How adorable she is. She's so itty bitty. I think actually in some places fennec foxes are kept as pets. I don't know. They're adorable. They're small. It's not like it's... You probably shouldn't... Well... Not saying go out and find yourself a fennec fox to keep as your pet, but they're probably better to keep as pets than, like, say, wolves or something, because at least if they bite you because of their wildness, it's probably not going to hurt as much as, you know, a bigger animal, bigger wild animal biting you. Oh, look at it, it's so cute! It's a little bushy tail! Ah, it's so adorable! You're pooping near the water, aren't you? Yes, you are. It's weird. It's kind of cool, though. Some of the animals will poop only near water. Jaguars do that. I once had, like, a jaguar exhibit with a bunch of little, like, water pools, and there was poop around every single pool. It's like, that's where they pooped. And that was it. Alrighty, well, I think that's it for this episode of Zoo Tycoon Diaries, the Challenge Zoo. In the next episode, we'll do some more challenges, hopefully. And I know, I'm going to eat something there now because I'm starving. See you in the next episode.